Hi.
Hello.
Howdy.
Good morning. Hey.
Morning. Or good afternoon. Oh, you're on the cell now, right?
Are you in Seattle, Harvey?
Oh, me. Oh, no, I'm still here in Boston.
Ah. Okay.
We have to head to the airport early today because Mike Pence is also arriving in Logan.
Great.
Oh.
We're about to leave, so we want to avoid that mess.
Ah, exciting. I don't know that we even have that much of an agenda today. We have Ed for talking about VPP. I guess we'll talk about the data plane API stuff. Was there anything else that anyone wanted to? Oh, I guess someone just put the quote partner page up for discussion. Is that you, Chris? You're gonna talk about that?
Yeah, I'll give people an update and kind of fix it. I'm updating a PR right now, so.
Great, thank you for handling that.
Hey, so cool.
Yeah, it's up to you, Ed, if you want to start or you're gonna wait a couple of, I
Happy
mean,
to kick off.
yeah, I think we might as well just get going. So go for it.
Cool. So I'd come to talk to you guys, I think back in November, and we've talked to periodically from time to time since about the work to integrate the VPP user space host stack so that it's something that can be used from Envoy. As a host stack, it scales unbelievably. It uses very, very few resources. It's faster than hell, and it will do TLS offload, including coming soon doing TLS offload to hardware where available. So there are some definite advantages to that thing available, plus the fact that we're more than happy to do whatever interesting thing you'd like done in your host stack on relatively fast turns. So what I was wanting to update you guys on is a couple of things. Number one is we do actually have it working now. It is ugly as sin, as you would expect for the just getting it working stage. And so we're hoping to be able to push what I would call sort of a conversational PR in the next couple of weeks that'll essentially sort of say, okay, this works. Here are some modularity points in the core that we kind of needed to make it work. Here's a plugin that we built to take advantage of those modularity points for VPP to be useful. And there's not directly an expectation that this would be something that would be merged as a PR. We want to get something out there so we can garner feedback from folks and get a sense of, okay, what seem like good ideas, what don't seem like good ideas, what might be better ideas if they were a little bit different, those sorts of things. So I wanted to sort of let you guys know. We're hoping to be pushing a PR in the next couple of weeks. We'll probably be in a position to discuss that PR at the next Envoy meeting. So just wanted to first let you guys know that was coming. Do you guys have any questions so far on that?
Yeah, that's great. My main ask is that when you push the PR, if it's in the PR description or if there's just like a short Google Doc or something, just if you could make sure that you kind of give like a little outline of what was done and why. I think that would make reviewing it a lot easier.
Yes.
And just one other comment for people on the call. There's been some private email threads. There's a parallel effort going on with the folks who are working on Cilium. So that's the eBPF kind of also kernel offload type stuff. You probably can speak to it more, Ed, in terms of what it is and how it's different than yours. But I just wanted to say briefly that there is some overlap in terms of kind of what the Cilium folks will want to do, and I think what the VPP folks will end up wanting to do. So I'm just wanting to make sure that when we discuss these extension points, that we get kind of both camps together so that we don't do this one modularity point only to realize that it doesn't work for Cilium.
Yeah, that's actually a good point. As you know, there's been some private discussion. I've emailed back and forth of it with Thomas Graf, and I think the position, as I understand it, was they sort of wanted to see what we were doing, and then we could discuss from there. And that's fine. And there seems likely to be overlap. I would be shocked if it were complete overlap in terms of needs, just
Yeah,
because
that's
of the
fine.
difference in logical approaches.
Yeah, no,
Yep.
I mean, it's not like it doesn't have to be 100%. I would also be shocked if there's 0% overlap. So
Yeah, I would be too. I would
be a shame if we like did a bunch of work and then, you know, they come along and say, oh, this doesn't quite work for what we need. So I just want to make sure that they're discussing kind of this initial PR just to make sure that everyone's on the same page.
Yeah, no, I would love that. That, as I said, I see it primarily as a conversational PR. I would be kind of shocked if it didn't change quite a bit going forward from what's initially pushed. I mean, I would be happy, but really, really surprised. Yeah. And then the other thing I wanted to do while we're on the topic is I wanted to introduce Dave Wallace, who's also on the call. He's the guy who's actually doing that work and will be pushing that PR. You want to say a couple words, Dave?
Sure. So I've been working with Keith Burns on this pretty much since we started the Envoy integration. I've worked on VPP since 2013, which is a couple years before we open sourced it. I'm a committer on the VPP project and the CSID project, which is the continuous system integration test infrastructure. And and my networking background so runs back 30 years, roughly.
Cool, welcome.
Cool. So I think that's it for me. I appreciate the couple of minutes just to let people know what's coming and the Great. Guidance on how to make it easier to sort of review.
Yeah, no, this is super. Looking forward to this. You want to talk really briefly, Harvey, about the data plane API stuff?
Well, I'm sure most people who are on the call are pretty familiar with what we're doing right now, but just a heads up for those who aren't, you know, as we discussed, I think on the last call, we want to reduce the friction when making changes to APIs and docs and which relate to a specific change. Right now, there's usually a 3-commit dance that's necessary to actually happen to actually make any of these changes. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually merge Dataplane API with the main Envoy repo. We'll still maintain a separate Dataplane API repo, which will be a read-only mirror of the API relevant portions of the main Envoy repo. And that's all going to happen at the beginning of next week. At the end of the day on Friday, we're going to stop merging things from Dataplane API. And we're also going to sort of close out any open PRs at that time. And it'll be the author's sort of responsibility for recreating these back in the main Envoy repo. This is unfortunately a bit of additional overhead that folks will be exposed to, but it's probably the most efficient way of making this happen in a distributed way. And hopefully come Monday, once we've made this migration, everything continues to work as is. Folks who have dependencies in Dataplane API should still keep working. And there will be just a different developer flow, which we'll document and send out to Envoy Dev a summary of.
Awesome. This is super exciting.
Okay.
Cool. Chris, you want to do partner page?
Yeah, so I'm sure some of you have saw the PR from, I think it was Turbine Labs, Jordan. So in CNCF, we allow projects basically to have a page that lists people who use the project or have commercial offerings. We kind of have guidelines in place for this. I'm taking a stab at reworking the PR to ensure it works with our guidelines. I'm basically going to lump it under our community page in Envoy and put it under there and say, here are interesting products and projects built on Envoy, and it'll be in alphabetical order. That's it. I'm doing the work myself to kind of collect projects and logos, but once the PR is done, it'll be free for people to add whatever they want there.
Cool. Yeah. We should maybe talk offline because there's a bunch of people that I ended up emailing about that, and I'm not really sure like who is engaged and
not. Yep, we had a conversation, but my goal is to have like a handful of them there, and then we could send an email to Envoy Dev or users and say, hey, PRs are welcome.
Perfect, great. Did you add the Google Summer of Code thing too?
Yes, sorry. Google is going to give a slot soon for Summer of Code. And my only ask from the Envoy team is please let me know your favorite proposal out of all of them.
do you think that we're going to, because I think we only got two proposals, maybe, like, do you think we're only going to get one slot? Is that what it looks
like? I just don't know how many slots Google will give me. So if for our insiders at Google, please tell them to give CNCF all the slots, and then we could potentially have two two projects for Envoy. But
okay, our opinions carry a little weight there.
let me talk to Harvey offline. Okay. Because I think we have two proposals. So I think if we had to choose one, we'll just have to go off and pick which one.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah. But just keep that in mind if we're kind of forced in that situation. Okay.
Yep. Sure. We'll do. Cool. I don't have anything else. Is there anything else that anyone out there wanted to chat about? Oh, cool. Sounds like we can call it early. All right. Have a good day, everyone. Bye.
Yeah.
Thanks. Have a great week.